Hello, I'm Cynthia Shaw, one of the challenge managers for NATO-DIANA. I'm going to talk about the energy resilience topic, microgrid technologies for disaster and conflict recovery. I'll begin by explaining why DIANA is interested in this particular problem. We are seeing greater evidence globally of the impact of climate change, including more frequent wildfires, longer periods of drought in areas, and extreme rainfall. These events are likely to be more frequent and severe, causing disruption and damage to civilian communities. Our old established power networks are unable to handle these extreme weather events. And when natural disasters strike, often there is devastating damage to our power networks and other infrastructure. The priority is therefore to restore essential services, such as power supplies to hospitals and other critical users, as quickly as possible to prevent making a humanitarian crisis worse. If we consider a military defence scenario, there may be a requirement to establish a defence base, potentially in an austere or unpredictable environment with limited or no access to a power grid. Here too, there may be a need for medical facilities. So the question is, how can we use novel technologies to quickly establish essential but also reliable power supplies in these different scenarios? Microgrids are one solution. They can be thought of as small-scale or localized power networks comprising of multiple distributed energy resources and multiple loads on demands on the system. They can operate independently, providing the only source of power. This makes them suited for applications where resilience is needed and can be targeted at small areas like hospitals, a camp or campus, or even a city. What we are looking for are disruptive technology solutions for modular microgrids capable of operating independently. The idea behind modular microgrids is that it allows for scaling and that they can be deployed rapidly. We are also interested in components or systems that are interoperable with other similar modular systems. For the capabilities, we are interested in primary power generation and energy storage. Here, we are looking to integrate multiple renewable or sustainable local energy sources, for example, solar, wind, and hydrogen. Tidal power generators could also be considered for coastal regions. High energy density storage systems such as flywheels, flow batteries or capacitors with high dielectric strengths, amongst other solutions, may also be considered. We are also looking for adaptive power control capabilities that can deliver high quality reliable power. Options for sensing and controls that are able to identify and isolate faults or damage and minimize the effect of a disruption event and recovery time would be welcomed. In such circumstances, the ability to reconfigure autonomously to ensure power is distributed uninterrupted to high priority loads would be highly beneficial. We are interested in control systems that can optimize the power distribution and charging of energy storage systems for greater efficiency. And lastly, we are seeking novel solutions that provide cyber-physical protection of the components and microgrid operation. To summarise then, we are looking for truly innovative capabilities leveraging deep tech solutions. These should be at technology readiness levels of 4 or higher. However, we will also consider technologies of lesser maturity if they could potentially offer high impact. As we are interested in dual use applicability, the solutions should be commercially viable and they must clearly address the defence and security needs outlined. Lastly, I will draw your attention to the deadline of the 25th of August to submit your proposals. To find out more about this challenge or the other two challenges on secure information sharing and sensing and surveillance, please visit us at www.diana.nato.int. You may also follow us on LinkedIn. The terms and conditions for the DIANA challenge can be found on the website. You can also download the full problem statement and read the guidance on how to apply. I would strongly encourage you to download the two templates, the one-page quad chart and the four-page paper. These can be found on the application portal, accessible directly from the DIANA website. The two documents should be completed in full for your application to be considered. I wish you all good luck with your applications, and I look forward to welcoming you to the DIANA programme in the not-too-distant future.